What's up guys, Kayla here. Welcome back to my channel. And if you are new here, make sure you hit that subscribe button, hit that bell button so you guys can be notified every time I post. But pretty much today is Vlogmas day 11. And pretty much today I'm gonna be recreating like this like Christmas tree macaroon or macaron, whatever they called, look. I haven't made them, like macarons are, I don't ever know the difference. So I haven't made those in a long time. So I was like, I want to make some. So I'm going to go ahead and make this inspired cookie Christmas tree. I thought it was really cute. So yeah, I already like kind of pre-measured some of my stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and just get started because I don't want this to be a too long of a video. But I'm going to go ahead and show you what I have now. Okay guys, so pretty much I'm going to tell you what I have. And I am following a recipe that I have done before. So pretty much I already put my 3 egg whites in a mixing bowl. Then I have 1/4 cup of sugar, 2 cups of powdered sugar, 1 cup of almond flour. Then I have my salt in these little containers. You'll need a pinch of salt. And then 1/4 teaspoons of, I think it's cream of tartar. That's what it's called. And yeah, also I do have some pink dye when I do the Christmas tree, or like the macaron part. I have some of the like decorating sugar sprinkles, I guess, and then the pearl sprinkles. And then I think I was gonna use one of these flowers maybe as like the star, because I have no other star. Then I'm gonna go ahead and use a piping tip 2A with, of course, a pastry bag. And I use these things so then it can be a little bit easier to clean, and if I wanted to switch out, if I wanted to, even though I'm not, I just like using these things with them better. But yeah, those are my ingredients. So I'm gonna go ahead and whisk the egg whites. So pretty much you're gonna beat the egg whites. I believe you can whisk it or whatever for a little bit. And then once it's foamy, you're gonna go ahead and add a pinch of salt. Okay, so as you can see a little bit, the egg whites are foamed up. Now I'm gonna go ahead and add a pinch of salt, then cream of tartar, or tart, whatever you call it. And then you're gonna go ahead and whisk this for about 8 to 10 minutes, and I'm gonna slowly add in the white sugar. I know you're not supposed to add this in too fast, so slowly add this in to the mixture. Okay, so pretty much right here should be the right peak of it. Let me move this over for you to go ahead and show you what the peak should look like. So when you go ahead and pull up, it holds its shape, as you can see. So this is the perfect part for the whites. I'm gonna go ahead and add the food coloring at this stage, and then you're gonna go ahead and mix it up for a little bit more until the color is pretty much colored. And when you are doing this part, if you wanted a certain color, make sure you do it a little bit darker, because I heard that you lose a little bit of its color when it's cooking. So you just go a little bit darker than what you're trying to get. And yeah, mix this up for a little bit till it's all incorporated and there's no like hidden streaks and things like that. Okay, so before I go any further, I do need to mix the almond flour and the powdered sugar together. And I did already shift both of these. I just didn't shift them together because I wanted to show you the ingredients separately. So yeah. And you do want to make sure your mixture is nice and fine, but yeah. Okay, so pretty much this is what the egg whites look like. They're nice, very pop pink. But again, they are gonna go down a little bit. So yeah, I'm fine with this color. Then you're gonna go ahead and pour your flour mixture into the bowl. And this is, I guess, a very critical part. You can't overmix and you can't undermix. And yeah, I know I've done it before. I think I undermixed it and they did not turn out right. But this is, again, practice. So it says on her recipe, a good 60 to 75 folds, which is when you go around the bowl and like you pull down around, pull down. It's a very nice workout. So yeah, I'm gonna just go ahead and do that for about 60 to 75 times. And I believe once you know it's done is when it's hold its shape. Some people do figure eights, but I just know like when it's like gently falling down, but it's like holding its shape a little bit when you drop it into it. But I'll show you once it's done. So I'm gonna just go ahead and fold it. Okay, so I did this about 70 folds, and this is how it is, if you can see that. But yeah, this is what it looks like. And now I'm gonna go ahead, let me actually see how the figure eight works. Figure eight works for this, so that's how you know the other show that it works. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this in a pastry bag. Okay, so now time for the piping. And as you do notice in the picture, it start off big and then goes its way up to be a little smaller. So I think honestly, I'm only gonna be able to do a couple of these. So, cause I don't know if I have enough, but it's good to like do a certain amount so then you can know you have enough. So I think these middle or just scattered everywhere, I'm gonna have the bigger ones and then just make my way up. So yeah, fast mode of that. Okay, so some of them are not as even, but I'm gonna go ahead and just, I did about seven of these. And I'm gonna go ahead, put this to the side, let it sit for a good hour. I feel like an hour is good when it has its skin. So I'm gonna go ahead, sit these ones out for an hour, and then I'm gonna just start working my way up of making smaller ones. Then now you're gonna go ahead and bang them once you finish piping them on the counter so that all the air bubbles can come out. And now you're gonna go ahead and let these sit out for a good hour until they have a nice skin over. And once they do, you're gonna go ahead and put the oven on 300 degrees. And you are gonna let them cook for 20 minutes and do not underbake them. And do not open the oven or like that will like lose all the heating and it will go flat. So don't do that. And yeah, we'll wait an hour now.
Okay, so pretty much these are the macarons. It's actually been a while. It's probably been like a couple hours, maybe like two. But they barely made a skin. But if I press too hard, it goes a little hard. I know before I can like easily do it and it wouldn't crack, but these what they look like. I already preheated the ovens at 300 Fahrenheit, and once that's done, I'm gonna put these in for 20 minutes and I'll let you know when I'm done.
Okay, so they did end up cracking a little bit. I don't know why, but I did set some of them like already as like a towers that I was gonna do. I did have leftovers, but some of the sides didn't work. So pretty much I'll have five of them, but I'm gonna go ahead and just layer buttercream. I did make the buttercream off camera. It's just regular American buttercream, and I use these tip 32, and I'm gonna just go ahead and swirl in between each one. And it did end up being pretty late. I don't know how, it just, these things took forever. Once I have finished doing that, I'm gonna go ahead and put some of these pearls in little sections of them. Okay, so this is the final look of it. I did throw some of the sprinkles away. I mean, I did throw some sprinkles on it. Some of them cracked, like I told you. But yeah, this is how they turned out. They look pretty decent.
Some are taller because some of them were the same size. If I didn't have a few of some, but yeah, this is what the overall look is. Okay, don't mind this on my head. I had to take a shower because it was getting late. As you can see, it is 8:51. I need to go to bed, take a late. So yeah, this is my final bit of my macaron Christmas tree thing. So yeah, if you guys like the video, let me know. Hit the like button. Make sure you guys comment down below, subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.